You will learn about the different types of natural resources. Let's begin by listing the resources that are most essential for our survival. Air, water, food, light and heat are some of the resources that are most important for the survival of living beings. We draw these resources from the environment and use them directly without much modification. These resources are called natural resources. Can you identify some other natural resources? The trees that produce oxygen for us. The plants and animals that provide us with food. The soils that we use to grow crops. The salt that we obtain from the sea water. The minerals that we use to produce other resources. These are also natural resources. Think of them as free gifts of nature. In some cases, tools and technology may be required to get the best possible use out of them. For example, the water that we drink is drawn from the lakes and rivers. But before it is supplied to our homes, it passes through a process of filtration. Similarly, the salt extracted from seawater is crude and contains impurities. Salt is purified before it reaches our tables. Natural resources can further be categorized into groups. These groups are based on their level of development and use, origin, stock and distribution. Depending on their level of development and use, natural resources can be classified into two groups: actual resources and potential resources. Resources whose quantity and quality are known and are being used in present time are grouped as actual resources. For example, the Bombay High Fields, which is India's largest offshore oil and gas field. It is being actively utilized, hence it can be considered as an actual resource. Some more examples of actual resources include the rich deposits of coal in Ruhr region of Germany, the petroleum in the West Asia, and the dark soils of the Deccan Plateau in Maharashtra. On the other hand, there exist resources in nature that are not being used at present. These resources can be grouped as potential resources. For example, uranium deposits have been discovered in the hills of Ladakh. However, its actual quantity and quality have yet to be established. It is currently a potential resource that may be used in the future. Another example is the presence of mineral oil in parts of India that have sedimentary rocks. Till the oil is not drilled out and used, it remains a potential resource. Similarly, there is a great potential of developing tidal energy along the coasts of India. However, till they are actually utilized, the tidal energy remains a potential resource. In some cases, the level of technology available at present may not be advanced enough to easily use these resources. However, at a later stage, potential resources may be converted into actual resources. For example, 200 years ago, high-speed winds were a potential resource. Today, we have wind farms which generate energy with the help of windmills. India is probably the fourth biggest wind power generator in the world. In India, wind farms are majorly located in the states of Tamil Nadu, Maharashtra, Karnataka, and Gujarat.